What's up, beautiful crafty people? This is the second part of my multicolored stamping technique videos. And it's Asia Marke here, Lemon Creation. Welcome! This is a video I created for Lindy's Gang. I'm showing you right now the swatches I have of Only Magicals. Yes, I have a lot of them. I've been designer for Lindy's for a few years already, so yes, I managed to get quite a collection. And so there are the four magicals I'm gonna be using: Tibetan Poppy Teal and Hydrangea Blue, and also Ponderosa Pines Olive and Cattail Copper Brown. And this is the second part, as I mentioned already. I already did one Halloween part, first part of the multicolored stamping with Lindy's. So you can check it out on Lindy's channel or on my channel. And I'm gonna be using this time my stamp designed by me for Indigo Blue. These funny wobbly winky lines. And what I'm doing is I am gonna be stamping with Magicals. The reason for that is to, of course, firstly, spice things up a little, because, well, you know, when we create, we try to always find new techniques, new cool ways of using our products. So why not, instead of, you know, having I don't know how many ink pads of different colors, you actually can have just a few Magicals and they will work as a paint, as a watercolors, and also as the ink pads. So I am taking with my brush a little bit of powder from the jars I have. You can dip a brush which is slightly wet into the powder, so the particles of the powder will attach to the brush and it actually, it's not gonna waste the powder. The brush cannot be very loaded with water, just if it has a little bit of water. I'm using this time actually four different brushes. They are all dry. That's the best way to do it, but as I said, if you need to dip a brush which is a little bit soaked in water, you can do it as well. As you can see, I'm taking a little bit of powder, putting it on the palette, and then adding a little bit of water. And the secret for stamping like that is not to add too much water. You have to add enough water to dilute the paint, dilute the magical, but not too much, so the paint doesn't run, and that's what I'm trying to show you here. They are staying in place, the paints, and that's the thing, because if your paints are too liquidy, they will run on the paper and the stamped image is not gonna be perfect. It's gonna be very distressed and not very clear. But if you don't add too much water, that's what you're gonna get. Of course, I made a small mistake here, because it seems that there are breaks in the stamp, which I rectify with the second one. For the second one, I actually moved a little the paint all under the stamp. And like that, I got this really, really crisp image, and the colors, which are changing, one goes into the other. Beautiful effect, which you wouldn't, I don't think you would get with the ink pads. To be honest, I don't even have colored ink pads. Well, I have distress oxides, which I don't even use that much, because when I want to do a colorful stamping like that, I just take my Magicals and I'll just go ahead with it. And you know, you can really do beautiful, beautiful things this way. And now I'm taking another one of my stamps also. And this is a well, no, it's not a square, it's a rectangle stamp, but I'm using only one part of it. So, you know, the part I don't want to use, I'm cleaning with a tissue, so like that I know I will not get the, you know, the edges which are rounded on the page. I just wanted to get the lines. And I use some splatter, but only because I just didn't want to go all this paint to waste. And I also decided to add some bigger circles, so again I use the stamp. I'm sorry, I'm missing words, I think. And the thing with Magicals, which is super great also, you just take a stamp like that, you go, you run it under the water, and it's completely clean. So, you know, you're not gonna waste it at all. There is no problem with it. It's not like with acrylics, which you can break the stamp if you don't clean it straight away. With magicals, you clean it very, very easily. And well, that's it for the multicolor stamping. Look at the effect, guys. I think it's really, really, really amazing to me. The colors which are changing. How would you otherwise make such a beautiful stamped image with so many colors? I have no idea. On top of that, of course, you can use flat magicals, which will give you flat colors without any shine. I opted this time for the magicals with shine, so I got my shine on top of everything else. So I have my colors, and then I have also parts where the stamps, the images are shiny, which is cool. And this is a part of the moth which I cut out from Maremi Smolart. It was actually her thank you note. She made a beautiful paper with thank you note, and there was a moth on it, and I think butterfly also. And I just thought the color wise it would suit the page very nicely, so I decided to use this one. And I'm adding a little bit of Rabons from Creative Expressions. That's an Andy Skinner sheet of Rabons. For this purpose, for this page, I'm gonna be adding only the numbers. I did not want it to add too much embellishments, just simply because I really want you guys to see the effects you can get with magicals. So I basically didn't want to cover the page, and that's how I decided to leave it. I let you listen to the music quietly, and I'll be back with you in a few minutes. So as I said earlier, I'm not adding too many embellishments. The last embellishment will be the words I'm gonna be using. They are words I design also, and I'm gonna be selling in my Shopify shop. And you need to fuzzy cut them, and then you know they are on the heavy paper, so you can put it on the paper on the page without any problems. And this is one of the sentences I am so much in love with. It really speaks to me. I have no idea. It's something which has a lot of meaning, and something I was thinking it's gonna work perfectly with the moth, because moth flies. And because I found moths are a little bit underestimated, I think. So I thought to myself, this is gonna be perfect for this page, and I hope you agree with me. And this is it. I hope you enjoyed that. If you have any questions about multicolor stamping and the Lindy's products or wherever else, just leave me a comment down below, and I'll be very happy to answer to your questions. And please share this video with your friends, subscribe to our channels, and I hope I'll see you soon in the next video. Bye bye!